And I'm in the Hayward Gallery on London's South Bank, and just opened here a fascinating exhibition devoted to the work of just one man, the English architect, Sir Edwin Lutyens. Now, you probably saw a very famous example of his work just recently, the very solemn center of the Whitehall Remembrance Ceremony, yes, the Cenotaph. Sir Edwin was born in 1869, and at the height of his career, he was deeply respected, almost revered. Some claimed he was the greatest English architect since Wren. But by the time the new school of architecture, the modernists, emerged in the 20s and the 30s, his career had begun to crumble. By the time he died in 1944, his work was largely disdained. But about 8-10 years ago, a newer group of architects, architectural students, came, and they have rediscovered Lutyens' work and found in it a new relevance. Walking through the exhibition, what memories come back to you? Is there any one particular thing that means a great deal?
I suppose all of it. Come back. I mean, I think the first thing that comes back is the collection of the bedroom furniture, which was for their original, when they were married in, what was it, 1897. And it was the furniture my father designed. And also seeing the casket, which meant so much to us. We were allowed to play with it occasionally when we've been very good as children.
And that's your father's own creation?
Yes, and he designed it at the time he fell in love with my mother. And he wasn't allowed to marry her because he was supposed not to have enough money. And he wasn't allowed to write to her. They mustn't meet or correspond, or there was practically no hope. But neither of them would give up hope. And he designed this for her really before there was any question. I think he hadn't declared his love for her even then. And inside, it's rather nice, all these little treasures he told her about. And here, there was a roll at the bottom of the casket. It's now a frame, but it was rolled up. And it was plans for our little white house. And my mother was rather surprised when he said that to her, because I think he'd only met her 3 or 4 times when he said that.
And what was in this tiny book?
He wrote a little fairy story in his own handwriting, which is in that little book there. And the other thing, he put an anchor in it, because that is a symbol of hope, which I never realized. And there was a pipe stopper, because that was a symbol of fireside evenings. And also she asked, particularly, because she was rather religious and he wasn't, if she could have a crucifix. And so he designed, which I think is that very beautiful silver and ebony crucifix there.
Did you ever actually live in a house designed by your father?
No, never as a family.
How odd. But did you ever live in one of them as a child?
Well,
I mean, your grandmother
house,
lived in one of
them.
Yes,
he designed a house for my grandmother, for my mother's mother. In Hertfordshire. It's called Homewood, where there's a little model of it here. That means a great deal to me too, now I come to think of it, because we spent all our Easter holidays there with her, and most of our Christmas holidays. And it was like our country home. And so that house of his, I can say I did live in.
When you were a child, were you aware what an important public figure your father was? I mean, were you very proud of him then?
I was terribly proud of him. I've always been frightfully proud of him. I've gone on being very, very proud of him. And when he perhaps been rather under a cloud since his death, I've been just as proud of him and thought everybody was very stupid not to be. I've never wavered for a minute in my feeling of pride and of him as an artist.
Then this exhibition must have enormous meaning to you. Do you think?
Yes, tremendous. It's a frightfully moving thing to me, that this exhibition, because I feel he's getting what he deserves, in a way. I feel he's entitled to this exhibition. I mean, perhaps that sounds, I shouldn't say it as his daughter, but I feel far enough detached from him.
But how sad that it's come too late for him to know that he is once again respected.
Well, I'm not sure that he doesn't know. I mean, maybe he does know. And after we don't know, do we?
Now, you feel that the cenotaph itself is a double monument, don't you? That
yes.
Not only for those who died in two world wars, but to your father's own life.
Yes, I think what I love about the Cenotaph, and he had a tremendous battle not to have a cross on it. And this he really fought might and main, because he said, after all, it wasn't only Christians who died in the war, but this was a monument to all our Allied troops. And after all, they were every kind of religion. And he said it was absolutely wrong to have a cross. And he won his battle, but it was a very big battle to win.
Now, it's strange to know now that it was not intended to be a permanent monument.
No, it was made of plaster. It had to be done in a great hurry. Lloyd George asked my father, I think 3 weeks before it had to be erected for the march past of the Allied troops. And so he did it very, very quickly, but perfectly, and it was put up in plaster in Whitehall, where it is now.
Well, then how did it become a lasting stone monument?
Well, it caught the public imagination and the feeling of the time. And there were lots and lots of letters in the papers saying, we want this, and we want this as our permanent memorial. And he gave it the name of a cenotaph, which means the tomb of somebody who was not actually buried there. That's why it was called the cenotaph. So in a way, he invented that word.
Do you think your father's actual character shows in his buildings?
I think it does. I think his great integrity shows, his sense of fun, his sense of form, and his originality. Because although he is a traditionalist, he is unique at the same time. I mean, his buildings aren't really like any others, they are his. And I can always recognize a building of his by little things, like you recognize somebody's handwriting.
It is handwriting, it is three dimensions.
It's a handwriting. And I can always tell, at least I feel I can, I might be quite wrong, but I always feel I can know if it's a piece of his furniture or a piece of his buildings. It's got his character in it.
Mary Lutyens, thank you.